ओके गाइस, सो वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 6 ऑफ एल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन सीरीज, राइट? सो इन लेक्चर नंबर 6 गाइस, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नाउ इन लेक्चर नंबर सीरीज, इट इज अ कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ बेसिकली न्यूक्लियोफिलिक एडिशन रिएक्शंस. सो इन न्यूक्लियोफिलिक एडिशन रिएक्शंस वी हैव सीन सो फार रिएक्शन विद HCN, रिएक्शन विद alcohols, that is acetyl and ketyl, and reaction with sodium bisulfite, that is used for the purification of carbonyl compound, right? So the one last reaction is there, right? That is fourth one for us, and it is basically reaction of carbonyl compounds with ammonia derivative. Okay, so this is also very important. Now what is it? Let's see. Reaction of carbonyl compound with ammonia derivative. So guys, here in this case, this is a general reaction. C double bond O and H2N and Z. Now you're like, sir, what is this H2N? What is the formula of ammonia? Ammonia formula is NH3. So if you replace that hydrogen with any other group, then it will become ammonia derivative. So whenever you do its reaction with ammonia derivative, so simply what we are going to do, we are going to take this water out, minus H2O, and we will get this product C double bond O and Z, right? And this is basically known as ammonia. This is basically known as what, guys? Ammonia derivative. Ammonia derivative. This is known as ammonia derivative. Understood? So this is how ammonia derivative reacts with what? Ammonia derivative reacts with what? Carbonyl compounds. And these reactions are very, very important for us. Okay. So let's discuss. So the first one is, you have to, like, compound name you have to memorize. This is carbonyl compound. And let's say my Z is H. Even in NCERT it is given like this. So if you will remove water from here, then what I will get? C double bond O NH. Okay. And this derivative we call what? Ammonia. Everyone knows, right? We call this what? We call this ammonia. And this we call it amine. I-M-I-N-E. Right? Similarly, if C double bond O. Okay. If it reacts with guys H2NR, if you replace the Z with what? Alkyl group, right? So this is, to you know very well, this is to amine. RNH2 is the formula of amine. So when it will react, so again we will replace water, we will take water out, then we will get C double O NR. Okay, and this is basically known as substituted amine. This is substituted imine, and it is also known as, guys, it is also known as Skip's base. It is also called Skip's base. Okay, Skip's base, right? Now third is, if Z group is replaced with OH, H2NOH, okay, so we call it hydroxylamine. Reagent name is hydroxylamine. Okay, take water out. So we will get C double bond O N O H. Okay, and this is known as hydroxylamine. And this is known as, this product formed is known as oxime. Very, very important. Okay, name of these things are important, right? Oxime. Fourth one is C double bond O H2N, and if I will replace Z with NH2, so this is to known as hydrazine, right? So again, take water out. So if you will take water out, we will get C double O NH2, and this is known as hydrazine, and this is known as hydrazone. This is known as hydrazone. Understood? Okay. Next one is, ओके सो दीज रिएजेंट तो यू हैव टू मेमोराइज, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके एंड वी विल डू इफ जेड वी विल रिप्लेस विथ NH phenyl. Okay, so guys, this is known as hydrazine. So if you replace one hydrogen of hydrazine with phenyl, so we will call it phenyl hydrazine. Phenyl hydrazine. Okay, so if you will do its reaction of phenyl with phenyl hydrazine, then again take the water out. What we will get this C double bond O N NH and this. Okay, and this is your phenyl hydrazone. This is phenyl hydrazone, right guys? Okay, so there are seven reactions like this. So I will write the seventh one now. Fifth one is clear. Now two more I need to write. Okay, so two are, sixth one is, guys, if you have carbonyl compound and if you will do its reaction with H2N, okay, H2N NH. Okay, this is the phenyl hydrazine, right? But if you will introduce NO2 group at second and fourth position, I'm introducing NO2 group, right? So the name of this will become 2,4, very important, okay, 2,4 dinitrophenyl, 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazine, 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazine, right? So if you will do its reaction, then again what is going to happen? Water, we will take out water. C double bond O N NH and this is NO2 and this is NO2, right? So what I will name it? I will name it 2,4 di nitro phenyl hydrazone. This is zine, so the product will be hydrazone, or in short name we also call it 2,4 DNP, dinitrophenyl hydrazone, right? We also call it what? 2,4 DNP, dinitrophenyl hydrazone. Understood? And the last one is C00. Okay, so if the Z group will be NHC00NH2. Okay, very very important. This compound is known as semi-carbazide. This compound is known as semi-carbazide. If you do its reaction with ammonia, so basically we have to do the same thing over and over again, right? So double bond N, NH, and C double bond O, NH2, right? So guys, in this case, what we will get? We will get semi-carbazone. Semi-carbazone, right? So you are like, sir, name is like, we have to memorize the name. Yes, this is very very important. Their name is very very important. In the end, the reaction is very simple. What you are doing, basically you are taking, so basically you are taking ammonia out, so that is very simple, right? But yes, you are taking water out, you are taking, but yes, products are important, like when this react, what will form, right? These kind of questions are quite common questions in your aldehyde and ketone chapter, right? So these are the reactions, of nucleophilic addition reaction of aldehyde and ketones. And the last one that is important for us is reaction of carbonyl compound with ammonia and its derivative. Understood? Okay, so now I will discuss one more example with you that is important, right? What is that? So usually they ask this question in your CBSE exam. Okay, what is that question? We will discuss. That is very famous question. Okay, so that is, question is, reaction of formaldehyde with ammonia. ओके सो क्वेश्चन इज रिएक्शन ऑफ फॉर्मेल्डिहाइड विद अमोनिया. ओके सो इन दिस केस गाइस यूरोट्रोपिन इज फॉर्म्ड. What formed? In this case, what formed, guys? In this case, urotropin is formed, right? So let me write about urotropin. Okay. So what happens? 6 moles of formaldehyde reacts with 4 moles of ammonia. 6 moles of aldehyde reacts with 4 moles of ammonia, and they form this compound CH2CH2N4 urotropin. Okay, and its structure, sometimes they are structure also. So first of all, you draw N4 like this. So one CH2 here, N, one CH2 here. Done. Okay, 1 minute. Like this, N, CH2, N, CH2, N, this is N, this is CH2, this is CH2, this is N, and this is CH2. Okay, 4 and 4, and then 2 here, 1 here, and 1 here. Okay, so this is your urotropin. Very, very important and theoretical type of information, type of questions, right? So whenever your formaldehyde reacts with ammonia, urotropin is used, right? So it is a medicine, it has medicinal use. Medicinal use, okay, it has medicinal use, that is urotropin, right? So this is how ammonia and its derivative reacts with carbonyl compound, right? So this is it. In this lecture we discussed the reaction of ammonia and its derivative and how to write, right? So important hai, काफी important hai, right? So that's it. This is our lecture number 6. In lecture number 7, reduction. In lecture number 8, oxidation. In lecture number 9, aldol condensation and Cannizzaro. And that will be the end of this chapter. So guys, reaction of carbonyl compounds with ammonia derivative is clear to us, right? Now, I'm picking up some important questions from your NCERT exercise basically. In-text question we have discussed, but these questions I'm picking up from NCERT exercise, right? So I'm going to explain these questions to you. Very, very important questions, right? So the first question is cyclohexanone forms cyanohydrin in good yield. What 2,2,6 trimethyl cyclohexanone does not. Okay, so what is the reason for that? So this is your cyclohexanone. Okay, so this is your cyclohexanone. So when it reacts with cyanohydrin, means it reacts with HCN, and you know the product very well. We will call it what? Cyanohydrin. So they are saying that it is in good yield. Okay, whereas when you will do the reaction of cyclohexane 2,2,6, so 1,2,3,4,5,6, okay, 4,5,6 with HCN, then okay, so cyclohexanone forms cyanohydrin good yield. What 2,2,6 trimethyl cyclohexanone does not, right? So why? Because what kind of reaction is this? Tell me, nucleophilic addition reaction, and rate of nucleophilic addition reaction is inversely proportional to, I told you guys, is inversely proportional to steric hindrance. So you tell me where carbonyl carbon is sterically crowded. So because of high magnitude of steric hindrance, the yield of product is not good. The yield of product is not good. Are you getting my point or not? Okay, because the reaction formation of cyanohydrin is nucleophilic addition reaction. Is nucleophilic addition reaction, right guys? Is nucleophilic addition reaction. So when it will react, so it is too sterically crowded. So that's why attack of CN minus is not easy, but here it is very easy because it's not sterically crowded. So that's why its yield is greater, but its yield is very, very small, right? So that's how you can write the answer. Okay, question number one, clear. Now this is question number two. This question I found very, very important question. Okay, and you will not believe that the same concept even has been asked in JEE exam also, JEE advanced. But this question is a part of NCERT only, right? So what is there? There are two NH2 group in semi-carbazide. However, only one is involved in the formation of semi-carbazone. So remember, I was discussing this. H2N NH C double bond O NH2. Okay, so when it reacts, so we will get this product C double O N NH and C double O NH2. What product we will get? We will get semi-carbazone, and this is semi-carbazide. So what is the question, guys? The question is that we have two NH2 group. This is one NH2 group and this is another NH2 group. So they are asking that out of two NH2 group, only one NH2 group is involved, right? So if I will ask you this question, then you will say, sir, it's hardly matter whether you write like this or whether you take water from this NH2 out or water from this NH2 out, it hardly matters. But no, it matters. It matters a lot, right? Now why? Because guys, this is an example of nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, reaction of ammonia derivative with carbonyl compound is also example of nucleophilic addition reaction. So you have little bit of sense of nucleophilic addition reaction, that in first step, basic step I will tell you, in first step to electrophile will attack. So suppose H plus is an electrophile will attack. Now in second step, nucleophile is going to attack. Who's going to attack? Nucleophile. So who's your nucleophile basically? H2NZ. Who's your nucleophile? Nitrogen is containing a lone pair. So nitrogen lone pair containing lone pair will attack over here. So this is acting as a nucleophile. So in order to act as a nucleophile, it must have electron density. It must have lone pair on it so that it can donate it to the carbon and form a bond. Yes or no? Right. Now, what is the problem? That only this NH2 group will involve in the reaction, but this NH2 will not. Now, what is the problem in that? The problem is, guys, because here the nitrogen can't act as a nucleophile. Why? Because it has lone pair. You are like, sir, but it has the lone pair. Yes, I'm saying it has lone pair. But guys, this lone pair is involved in resonance with C double bond O. It is involved in resonance. Okay. Lone pair of nitrogen is involved in resonance. Lone pair of nitrogen is involved in resonance. Due to this nitrogen cannot act as nucleophile. Due to this it can't act as nucleophile. Understood? So that is why this NH2 will not involve. What guys, what about here? So this, the lone pair on this nitrogen is still intact. It is not involved in resonance with anything, right? So its availability is there only, but its availability decreases due to the presence of resonance with C double bond O group. That's why this NH2 can't involve in a reaction what this NH2 can, because there is no resonance in case of this NH2, right? So that is why. Okay, what is answer? Answer is, okay, this NH2 will take part because its lone pair is not involved in resonance. is not involved in resonance. Point is clear to everyone? So this is very, very important question, and this kind of question can be asked in your your school exams basically, right? And I have seen in many previous year papers of your schools that they have asked these questions, right? And the last one is, now what is last one? So I will write here. So what is last one, guys? So the last one is this. So last one we have benzaldehyde, COOH. Okay, and we are doing its reaction with H2NCOONH2. Okay, so when I will ask you this question, so many students are also not able to answer it, but yes, you know, this is carbonyl group, aldehyde, and this is ammonia derivative. This is ammonia derivative. This is ammonia derivative, right? Okay, but listen, many students will do this mistake that they will take the water out. Okay, then dot they will write. So I'm writing like this. So they will write CH double bond N C double bond O NH and NH2. But let me tell you, this is wrong answer. That's why this question I find good question. This is wrong answer. Why this is wrong answer? You guys are smart. This nitrogen can't be involved. Why? Because its lone pair is involved in resonance. So this nitrogen can't be involved. So you have to rearrange it and you have to write it properly. C double O. Okay, so this NH2 will involve. So you have to write from this end. H2N NH C double bond O NH2. Okay, now take water out. Okay, so if you will take water out, minus H2O, then we will get this product. Okay, CH double bond N NH C double bond O NH2, right? And this is known as what? Semi-carbazone, because we are getting it from carbazide. Semi-carbazide. So this is known as semi-carbazone. Understood? So these are the important questions that I found in your NCERT, okay, and that you will ask me later on in the doubts also, right? So this is the very, very important, and even this question has been there in your JEE Advance also, right? This reactant was different, but yes, the concept was given like this only. They have right NH2 that is involved with CO in front, so that student will do this mistake. But no, now to you guys are smart, you will not do this mistake. Okay, so this is all about, guys, lecture number 6. Okay, that's it, done about lecture number 6. In lecture number 7, reduction. Lecture number 8, oxidation. Lecture number 9, aldol condensation and canizaro, and then aldehyde and ketone is over for us. So thank you very much.